Hi, Lori the Insurance Warrior here. People often contact me and ask, should I bother to appeal? And then they list all the reasons why they won't win. When we appeal an insurance plan, we are one person coming up against a huge bureaucracy dedicated to denying us. If you go into this believing that you're going to lose, then you will lose. Before we discuss any specifics about the appeals process, we need to have a paradigm shift. When I invented this whole appeal thing, I had a million reasons why I would lose. I had a stage 4 cancer. I had months to live. I had to single-handedly fight my local doctors and the insurance company. I began with no proof, no precedent, no strategy, no nothing. If I had not bothered to appeal, I would have been gone by 2007. I won my appeal because I opened my heart. And what I found there was courage, compassion, and a burning desire for truth and justice. I won not because of my skill set, but because of my heart. I've won cases with no proof and no precedent. I've won cases where people have already lost all of their appeals. In many of my cases, including my own, doctors didn't think that I would win. Lawyers didn't think that I would win. Friends and family didn't think that I would win. It just made me all the more determined. You don't have to follow all the steps that I do in order to win your appeal. As a matter of fact, I've seen folks win appeals by doing things that I would never advise doing. And yet they win. In 2014, I was losing a case in Illinois. The patient's sister-in-law, Valerie, was working with me. We'd fought our way through 2 appeal levels in 5 days. They weren't going to budge. We finally had to admit defeat. We were done. The next morning, Valerie called me. She said, "I've been thinking about this. It's just not right. I'm not going to let them do this to me." In that moment, she found her brave heart. I said, "I'll support you in any way that you need. Go for it." Valerie called the headquarters of the insurance company and asked to speak to the CEO. I would never in a million years suggest such a thing. Nobody at any insurance company is going to let you talk to any CEO. The person transferred her to a lower level executive in the HR department. We'd already done so many executive phone calls that Val was expert at delivering a 1-minute summary of our case. The executive agreed to read the appeal. After reading it, she called Val and said, "This is just not right. Of course this needs to be approved." She took our case all the way back up the food chain. Within a few hours, the life-saving surgery was approved. We had already lost. I had thrown all of my strategies at it. The only thing that had changed was Valerie's heart. When she felt the justice, the rightness, the power of it, she became relentless. When you ask, should I bother to appeal? What I hear is, should I bother to stand up for myself? Should I bother to fight for what's right? Yes, you should. But first, get your heart right. Then start planning how to win your appeal. Thank you for watching my video. Now smash that subscribe button, like the video, and subscribe to my channel. See you next week.